Hey guys, my name is Frank, and you will know everything about HTML tables by the end of this video. Alright, let's do this. Let me create a very simple table for you. I'm using a free online HTML editor hosted by htmlonline.com. I have a what you see is what you get editor on the left, and I can edit the source code on the right. Whichever I edit, my changes are showing up in the other one as I'm typing. I'm adding some demo content, styling it, increasing the font size to fit the page, highlight the text. Yeah, looking nice. There we go, it's all that simple. Our first table is ready in just a couple of seconds. Let me add some gibberish text to demonstrate how we used to place an image next to the content. In the good old days of the internet, we used tables to position everything on a page. We added a 2x1 table, put the image in the first cell and the text in the second. Of course, nowadays we just float the image and set the margin so it doesn't touch the text. And when I say we use tables to position everything, I really mean it. We use tables to build the layout of the whole website back then. Here we have a sidebar, a footer, maybe we need a logo as well. For this, I'm adding a new cell with an image. Too big. And ta-da! We have a web page in just 20 lines. I want to show you a few examples. This is an old website about frogs. You wouldn't guess, it is a big table. Do you remember Space Jam? I believe I can fly. This site definitely doesn't look like a table, but guess what? It is a table. Now check out this other table website from 1996. Table. And now the big question, why did we stop using Microsoft Excel to lay out a website if it was so straightforward? The answer resides in your pockets. Mobile revolution. Because every website must be compatible with your desktop, your laptop, your tablet, your mobile, your smartwatch, your Google Glass, your fridge, and I don't know what else they're gonna sell you. Never mind. While a few years ago the biggest problem of a designer was to make the site work on Internet Explorer, now the challenge is to make it look good on different screen sizes, and we can't use fixed grid layout for this because sections have to slide below each other. So tables must be replaced with divs. There's a great free online tool which can help you convert your HTML tables to structured div elements. HTMLcleaner.com. All you have to do is to paste your code in the source editor, or if you're copying your table from a Word, PDF, or any other editor, then paste it directly in the visual editor. Make sure that the table to div conversion cleaning option is enabled, and press clean. Let's see what we got. Every table tag is now replaced with divs, having custom classes. Table, table body, table row, table cell. Now this structure by itself won't make the divs look like a table. You will need to style them. The website offers three different CSS templates which you can customize according to your needs. It's all that simple. Find all the links I mentioned in the video description. Go ahead, give them a try, share it with your friends. They're all free. Thank you for watching. Cause I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day.